Hey, my name is Musketon, and today I'm going to show you how I use the DynamicSketch plugin and some basic tools to create an illustration. So first off, I'm going to start out using the ellipse tool to create a circle like this. I'm going to apply a fill with no stroke. Next, I'm going to create a different circle in the center of the first circle. And on this one, I'm going to apply a stroke with no fill. Now I'm going to jump over to the stroke panel and add some more weight. I'm going to select them both, and I'm just going to scale them down. Now I'm going to use the DynamicSketch tool. And basically, DynamicSketch is just a more advanced brush. So I'm just going to draw the top eyelids like this. And now I'm going to do the exact same for the bottom eyelids of the eye. At this point, it doesn't really matter how the lines look, because you can always use the direct selection tool to select anchor points and to drag and drop the lines until you get something that you like. So I'm just dragging and dropping. So this is the base of the eye, two circles and two strokes. Now I'm going to select the lines that I just created and add some weight. The beauty of DynamicSketch is that you can cut away overlapping pads. So if you hold down the shift key, you can cut away the pads that you don't need. This is like a really fast way of working in Adobe Illustrator. So as you can see, I'm holding down the shift key and cutting away the stuff that I don't need. Now I'm gonna apply profile on the strokes like this and gonna add some more weight once again. Maybe create some more lines using DynamicSketch. So basically what I'm doing right now is I'm just using DynamicSketch, basic shapes, the stroke panel, and some profiles to create something that looks like an eye. Next, I'm gonna select this circle and I'm gonna copy it. I'm gonna paste it in the exact same spot. So now if you scale it, get something like this. I'm gonna hold down the Alt key on the keyboard and drag them down like this. Select them both, jump over to the Pathfinder, minus front, and now you have something that looks like shading. Once again, really simple stuff that everybody should be able to do. Adding some more lines using the DynamicSketch tool, like this. And next, I'm going to create the eyelash really fast. I'm going to do this using the pencil tool. I'm just going to create strokes like this. Can see really fast. I'm going to select all these strokes. I'm going to apply some weight in the stroke panel, apply a profile like this, and you're done. I'm going to do the exact same thing for the eyebrow, like this. Just create a line, some lines that look like an eyebrow, like this. Select all the lines you just created. Add some weight, add a profile, and you're done. At this point, I'm gonna top it off with a highlight. So once again, using the ellipse tool again, just creating a circle on top using a white fill to create the illusion of highlights. And now, because we're almost done, you can add some more lines to make it more detailed like this. If you want to be inspired by some different artists, you can go over to the Estude Graphics website and watch some more 10-minute scale videos.